Hello and welcome to Bread of Life. Our speaker for this week is Pastor Greg Hendrickson of New Haven.
Ezra chapter 4, verse 24 to chapter 5, verse 2. Then the work on the house of God in Jerusalem stopped, and it ceased until the second year of the reign of Darius, king of Persia. Now the prophets Haggai and Zechariah prophesied to the Jews in Judah and Jerusalem in the name of the God of Israel who is over them. Then Zerubbabel and Jeshua arose and began to rebuild the house of God that is in Jerusalem, and the prophets of God were with them, supporting them. Sometimes Christians get stuck. In other words, we stop making progress in our journey with Jesus. Perhaps we set out to grow in our knowledge of God by reading through the Bible. But then we hit Leviticus, and we get bogged down, and we put the Bible back on the shelf. Or perhaps we set out to build a stronger marriage, but then we hit misunderstandings and distractions and stressors, and we're tempted to disengage. Or perhaps as a local church, we set out to actively reach out to our community with God's word and Christ's love, but over time we turn back inward and settle for just maintaining the status quo. Sometimes Christians get stuck. And that's exactly the situation that God's people in Ezra chapter 5 found themselves in. They had started rebuilding the temple, but then they hit some opposition described in chapter 4, and so they stopped. For 16 years, they made no further progress. But in Ezra chapter 5 and 6, God does three things to get his people going again. First, we'll see that God's word wakes us up. Haggai and Zechariah proclaimed God's message in the name of the God of Israel. They spoke with God's authority and under God's direction, and the result was Zerubbabel, the governor, and Jeshua, the high priest, rose up and began the work of rebuilding. And then Haggai and Zechariah stayed with the people, helping and encouraging them all along the way. Now, Haggai and Zechariah had very different personalities and approaches. We can see this in the books named after them. Haggai was down to earth, in your face, and confrontational. He said, "You people say it's still not time to rebuild God's house. But look at all the money you've spent on renovating and decorating your own houses. God's house lies in ruins, and your houses have fancy wood paneling. Consider your ways. Your lives are not going well. You're crazy busy all the time, and the reason is because your priorities are out of whack." Well, guess what? The people listened to Haggai's straight talk. They obeyed, and so Haggai reassured them and encouraged them with God's promise. "The Lord says, I am with you." Now, Zechariah was a bit different. He was more of a heavenly-minded visionary. God gave Zechariah visions in the night, visions of God's judgment and mercy and glory, visions of God's judgment and forgiveness, visions of God bestowing peace and wholeness and joy. Zechariah's visions lifted people out of their present troubles and pointed the people to the greatness of God, to the majesty of his unfolding plan. In fact, many of Zechariah's visions point to the Messiah himself. Well, God used these two preachers, Haggai and Zechariah, different as they were, to wake his people up, to stir them into action, and God still awakens and equips, sustains, and encourages his people through his powerful, life-giving word. Sometimes God uses straight talkers like Haggai to challenge us with God's truth. "Consider your ways. You're running after cars and careers and vacations. Your house is immaculate, but your relationship with God and your relationships with people are a shambles. You're not flourishing because your priorities are out of whack." Sometimes we need a challenging word like that. But sometimes God also brings heavenly-minded visionaries like Zechariah, who can lift us out of our petty concerns and fix our eyes on the beauty and holiness and overwhelming majesty and love of God. The Apostle Paul says, "Oh, the depths of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God, how unsearchable his judgments and his paths beyond tracing out." And Paul prays that we would have power to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ. See, when we stand in awe of God's greatness, when we're filled with his goodness, the whole world looks different. God's word awakens us.
You've been listening to Pastor Greg Hendrickson of New Haven, and this has been Bread of Life, a program to encourage you from God's Word.